What's going on, my fellow rock and rollers? Don't forget to hit the bell notification icon to be notified every time I put out a new video on my channel. The Ramones bassist Dee Dee Ramone was only 50 when he died in 2002. He lived a pretty tragic life that was consumed by drugs, alcohol, and rock and roll. This is his story. Dee Dee Ramone was a founding member and main songwriter, as well as the bassist of the hugely influential punk rock group The Ramones. Dee Dee's struggle with substance abuse was no secret, as he would publish an autobiography in the late 90s and documented his crippling addiction. The story of the Ramones is one of great tragedy, as Dee Dee would die almost within a year of when frontman Joey Ramone passed away at the age of 49 from cancer. Originally named Douglas Glenn Coven, Dee Dee was born in 1951 in Fort Lee, Virginia. His father was in the military and his mother was a German citizen. Given his father's profession, Dee Dee moved around a lot as a kid, and by his own admission, he would claim his childhood was lonely. When he was an infant, his family would relocate to West Germany, where he would stay until the age of 15. His father would struggle with alcohol abuse, and that resulted in his parents splitting up. Dee Dee, his mother, and sister would move back to the States, finding a new home in Forrest Hills, New York. It was in Forrest Hills that he met two other guys named John Cummings and Thomas Erdelyi, later dubbed Johnny and Tommy Ramone, who were playing in a band named Tangerine Puppets. After some discussion, the trio decided to start their own band. They would add friend Jeffrey Hymann, who was a drummer in another band named Sniper, to cement the lineup. They would call themselves the Ramones. They would draw inspiration from the Beatles' Paul McCartney, who would use the alias Paul Ramon when staying at hotels. Each member of the band would change their surname to Ramone as an act of solidarity. Douglas Coven would become Dee Dee Ramone, John Cummings would become Johnny Ramone, Thomas Erdelyi would become Tommy Ramone, and Jeffrey Hymann would become Joey Ramone. It was a struggle at first, as the Ramones had a revolving cast of members in different positions, as Dee Dee originally was the vocalist while Joey was a drummer. And after some maneuvering, Joey became the vocalist while Dee Dee would focus on bass, as he found singing and playing bass at the same time difficult. But he still had vocals on a few Ramones tracks. A year later, in 1974, the band made their live debut and soon made a name for themselves on the New York music scene. Mixing pop with their hard rock influences, including The Who, the MC5, and the Stooges, they would soon become synonymous with the New York punk rock scene, using just three chords to write songs. By 1976, the band released their self-titled debut album, which included the punk rock anthem Blitzkrieg Pop. Dee Dee would end up being one of the band's most prolific lyricists and songwriters, penning such tracks as Poison Heart, Rockaway Beach, and 53rd and 3rd that documented his life as a street hustler. Something that would hamper Dee Dee for much of his life starting in his teenage years was drug addiction, especially as the musician took a liking to heroin. In the intro to Dee Dee's Ramones book, Lobotomy, Legs McNeil would write, "Dee Dee was an F-up whose life was a living disaster. He was a male prostitute, a would-be mugger, a heroin user and dealer, an accomplice to armed robbery, and a genius poet who was headed for an early grave, but was sidetracked by rock and roll." In addition to drug abuse, Dee Dee would also suffer from mental illness, which would put a strain on his first marriage to his wife Vera Boldis, and the couple would separate in 1990 before finalizing their divorce in 1995. In the years that followed, the Ramones would undergo numerous lineup changes, with Dee Dee remaining intact until 1989, after playing on 11 records. It was during his time in rehab in 1987 that he soon learned about rap music, which changed his career path following his exit from the Ramones.
I always loved playing live with the Ramones, but I had to kind of like go my own way and like stick up for myself and do what I wanted to do. They're freaked out, at first they didn't believe it. They thought I was just going through a midlife crisis, that I'd be back.
He won't be, though, and the traditional artistic differences aren't the only reason why. Finally clean and sober after years of drug and alcohol problems, Dee Dee felt that his hard-won sobriety was being endangered by the Ramones' relentless road work.
The Ramones always attracted, like, people who were heavy into drugs and stuff, and the people that come around, it's a nightmare. And somehow a couple of them will always get backstage, and there it is. And sometimes I just hung in there by the skin of my teeth, and you know, I needed a break, you know, I had to get off the road, and they just kept on getting booked and booked and one commitment after the other, and, you know, finally I just had to make a decision. It was like either that or break my sobriety, and, you know, I chose to not break my sobriety. I wish them.
Following his exit from rehab, Dee Dee would record the rap-influenced track Funky Man in 1987, but the song wouldn't show up on his solo albums. And it was towards the end of his stint in the Ramones that Dee Dee would frequently show up to gigs in full rap clothing, which frustrated his bandmates. After leaving the Ramones in 1989, he would embark on a career as a rapper named Dee Dee King, which put out a few solo albums and would collaborate with other artists, but it was ultimately unfruitful. In 1989, Dee Dee would release his first rap record called Standing in the Spotlight. The album was a commercial disaster and was widely panned by critics, with some considering it to be one of the worst albums in the recording industry. The album blended old-school hip-hop and doo-wop with punk rock, and even featured Blondie's frontwoman Debbie Harry singing backup vocals on the song Mashed Potato Time and German Kid, with the track German Kid also featuring Dee Dee rapping in both English and German. Dee Dee, of course, picked up German when he was living in Europe as a kid. The one track on the album named The Crusher would end up being re-recorded by the Ramones on their 1995 record Adios Amigos, and it would prove to be the band's last record together. In the early 90s, Dee Dee would play guitar in punk rock legend G.G. Allin's band The Murder Junkies, but he would only be in the group for 1 week and was interviewed by director Todd Phillips for the G.G. Allin documentary Hated, G.G. Allin and the Murder Junkies. It was during this interview that Dee Dee didn't even know G.G. Allin's band name, and even though he appears on the film soundtrack, he never actually played a live gig with the group, only playing in rehearsals. And by 1992, Dee Dee would move on to his next project, the short-lived Dee Dee and the Chinese Dragons, which would be followed by the more successful Dee Dee Ramone's ICLC, which stood for Intercelestial Light Commune, which would last from 1994 to 1996. The group would only put out one record, 1994's I Hate Freaks Like You, while also recording a four-track EP titled Chinese Bitch. The group would tour extensively during the mid-90s, playing 22 countries over a 10-month period, and it was during this time that Dee Dee would meet Barbara Zampini while searching for his lost guitar outside his hotel in Argentina. Zampini was a fan and bass player herself, and they would later marry, and she would be with Dee Dee until his death. As Dee Dee Ramone's ICLC headed back into the studio to record their follow-up record in 1996, they were subsequently dropped by their label. Following that career disappointment, Dee Dee would team up with former Ramones drummer Marky Ramone and tour as a Ramones tribute act. Dee Dee would be invited to the final Ramones show at the Palace in Los Angeles on August 6, 1996, and would perform lead vocals on Love Kills. By the late 90s, Dee Dee would relocate to Los Angeles to pursue a career in acting while still working on his music, but his Hollywood career would stall. He would, however, land a central role in the 2002 low-budget release Bikini Bandits, in addition to recording a song for the movie soundtrack, which would feature his wife on lead vocals. And in 2002, Dee Dee would make one of his final public appearances when the Ramones were inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, but sadly, several months after that appearance, Dee Dee would be found dead in June of 2002 by his wife Barbara in their Hollywood apartment. The cause of death was officially ruled to be a heroin overdose. Dee Dee was scheduled to perform at the Majestic Ventura Theater around this time, but the show would end up being a memorial tribute show to him. Dee Dee would end up being laid to rest at the Hollywood Forever Cemetery close to his former Ramones bandmate Johnny Ramone. His headstone reads, "Okay, I gotta go now." Without him, the Ramones likely would have never existed, and the history of punk rock may have never been the same. Let me know your guys' thoughts on Dee Dee Ramone in the comment section below. And as always, if you have suggestions for future topics, let me know down below as well. Take care.